I'm in right time.
Yes, sir. Sir, shall we start?
Up to you.
Okay, sir. So, good afternoon, participants. Welcome for the heart session of the day. We have our respected sir, Professor Sukumar Nondi sir. So, before the initiation of the session, I am introducing sir to the participants. So, on behalf of the Department of Computer Science and Engineering, National Institute of Technology, Sikkim, it is my privilege and pleasure to welcome Professor Sukumar Nondi sir from Indian Institute of Technology, Guwahati, in this session to deliver an expert lecture. Professor Nondi sir is an eminent academician and has 30 years of teaching, research, and administrative experience. Presently, he is the senior most professor in the Department of Computer Science and Engineering at Indian Institute of Technology, Guwahati, and also working as the Dean Infrastructure Planning and Management at IIT Guwahati. He passed his BSc in Physics from Calcutta University in 1984, BTech in Electrical Engineering from Calcutta University in 1987, M.Tech in Computer Science from Calcutta University in 1989 and did his PhD in Computer Science and Engineering from IIT Kharagpur in 1995. Sir was also a visiting senior fellow in School of Computing Engineering, Nanyang Technology University, Singapore. Sir joined IIT Guwahati in 1995, where he has performed many academic and administration roles like Head of the Department of CSE, Dean Academic Affairs, Dean Research and Development, Deputy Director, Chairman GATE 1999, Vice Chairman IIT Joint Entrance Examination 2000, Head Center for Linguistic Science and Technology, Head Center for Educational Technology, Member of Board of Governors, etc. at IIT Guwahati. In addition to that, sir is also holding the positions of Member of the Executive Council of Guwahati University, Member Board of Governors, CIT Kokrajhar, Member Board of Governors at Trigunasen School of Technology, Assam University, Silchar, Member Senate at National Institute of Technology, Mizoram, CIT Kokrajhar, NIT Manipur, and also the Member Board of Governors at NIT Arunachal Pradesh. In addition, sir was also the Member Academic Council, Boroland University, Assam, Member Academic Council, NERIST, Arunachal Pradesh, and many more. Sir has expert research areas in computer networks, computer and network security, data mining, machine learning, VLSI design and testing, computational linguistics, etc. 23 PhD scholars had already awarded PhD degree under his supervision, and at present, about 18 are doing their PhD under his supervision. In addition to the above, 83 M.Tech students already completed their dissertation under his guidance. Sir has 111 research publications in reputed journals, 326 publications in reputed international and national conferences. In addition, he has co-authored one book, six book chapters, and edited three books. He has delivered 25 keynote lectures, invited talks in international and national conferences, and delivered many expert talks in workshops, short-term courses, faculty development programs, etc. Sir has completed 6 consultancy projects and 28 R&D sponsored projects of total costing of ₹169 crores. Sir has received several national and international awards for his academic achievements, and currently he is the Fellow of Indian National Academy of Engineering, Fellow of the Institution of Electronics and Telecommunication Engineers, Fellow of the Institution of Engineers, and also the senior member of ACM and IEEE. Till today, Sir has published 488 research articles, which are well recognized by the eminent scientists and researchers throughout the world, and that achieves till today 5,515 citations with H index 32 and I-10 index 127. So thank you, sir, for being here. Now I invite you to deliver the lecture. Over to you.
Thank you. Thank you for introductions. Good afternoon to everyone. So at the evening time, I have to make you busy instead of doing any other work. Okay. So I kept my talk as very interesting. I think you can see my slides. I think you can see my slide.
Yes, sir. It's visible.
Yes, sir. Okay. Yes, sir.
Okay. Hope this. Those who are speaking, please keep the microphone off mute conditions. If you have any question, obviously you can disturb me and we can have discussions. Our department, we are center of excellence in one of the area is called wireless security, in which IoT security is one of them. And we are working in this direction. Several PhD students are working. And I feel this will be very interesting. So I kept this topic for you as your future challenges or future research requirement. So my topic is IoT security issues and challenges, which may help you in your future career or future directions. My agenda of this talk is, how secure is IoT? What are the common protocols in IoT available? In these protocols, any kind of vulnerabilities exist? And key aspect of securing IoT protocols. Please remember, the slides are prepared from internet available slides. So you can find it in net also. And it is a popular talk. In depth, if you need, you have to talk to me or our group. Let us talk a little bit about IoT, why IoT is so important. If you go back, Industry 1.0 or 1.0, 1784, some mechanization came up, steam power, weaving loom and other things came up. Almost 90 years later, Industry 2.0 came up, that is, mass productions in assembly line, things, electrical energy, all these came in picture, big revolutions. It was a big revolutions. And another 100 year later, it came up Industry 3.0, and that is automation of most of the things, how to automate it, industry, then computer subsequently, and electronic devices. And today, we have Industry 4.0, where physical cyber physical system, Internet of Things, and network everything in one and come to industry 4.0. Similarly, there is another set of groups from Japan. They come up with society 5.0. If you go and search in the internet, you will get society 5.0. It's a similar dimensions and it's around the human requirement, everything. So, as if we go society 5.0 or 5.0 and industry 4.0, you will find most of the important requirement in cyber physical system is Internet of Things. So, everywhere devices are exist, and so our first and foremost requirement to know Internet of Things. So if I go and check what is the definition of Internet of Things, one new person, if they search, or if person search, one can search in the internet, it will be confused because there are multiple definitions exist, and some of the definitions are such a big encompassing everything is difficult to say that, oh, everything is there. So that's why if you go and check, there are multiple definitions, but that boils down to a similar kind of environment at the end. I am giving only one kind of definitions, but all definitions are equally acceptable. As IoT till now, not one standard exists. It has multiple standard, multiple groups are coming up their own way. And so it will be difficult to say that it is one kind of protocols or one set of protocols is only used. It some proprietary products available, some group products available, some things available, but none of them are acceptable by everyone. But in nutshell, Internet of Things is the network of physical object, that is devices, vehicles, buildings, and other items embedded with electronics. That is the requirement. Objects should have embedded with electronics, software, and they do some sensing or actuating, and they should have a connection among themselves or connectivity that enable these objects to collect and exchange data. And what indirect mean is that each and every device having some embedded electronics, some softwares, can do some sensing or actuations with actuations, and they communicate each other, and finally the data can be collected sitting at one place in whole world, any place, anywhere, any times. So we can read things, connect objects, whatever. So if we go by this smart home, in a smart home several items are there, like fridge, microwave oven, heater, geyser, AC, TV, mobile phone, whatever, and door locks, CCTV camera, all can be connected into the network and used for a particular purpose in a home pond, the smartphone. Similarly, smart city, which is in India, the smart city project, there are a lot of cities are under smart city project, require a lot of IoT devices and sensor and actuators, and their exchange of data and processing. Similarly, smart supply chain. If we look into the growth, the slide is up to 2020, taken from Cisco. They found that world population is not increasing, it remain below 10 billions as a whole, whereas the devices rapidly increasing 5 times faster than the any electricity and telephone, and rapidly increasing. And on 2020, it was 50 billion smart objects, and it can go up to any numbers. Well, as I mentioned, IoT device or IoT components having different names. European group say machine-to-machine design. Please remember here, device-to-device communication is electronic communication engineering. Two devices can communicate each other. For them, we require a channel to be assigned so that they can communicate happily. But here it is talks about machine-to-machine, is not device-to-device. So software, intelligence, and others are built in here. Cisco coined the word called Internet of Everything. We'll see few slides later. We have another name is called Internet of Anything, which is given by Datanova. World Size Web, given by Bruce Schneier. Those who have done security and other related cryptography related things, they know. And Terminator movie, if you have seen, the Skynet. It's basically various name, but one concept, that is Internet of Things. This is Internet of Everything given by Cisco. Cisco came up with a 4 specific pillar. One is people, another is process, one more data, and last things. So they come up with this thing, Internet of Everything means connecting people in very more relevant and valuable ways with the process, delivering right information to right person or a machine at right time. And obviously they have to use the data for leveraging. This data will be generated by things, physical object or object connected to the internet and each other, intelligent decision making. And all these depends on the big data or data, leveraging data into more useful information for decision making. How smart are IoT devices? As much as we can imagine. Today's IoT devices are too much intelligent, can do a lot of things. So what we have learned, our course, our curriculum, and our present day infrastructure, we have some kind of infrastructure, and those infrastructure having interfaces, different heterogeneous infrastructure, we have different heterogeneous interfaces. And we try to define a middleware or unified platform. Once this unified platform we make it, we write the different applications interfaces, and then we write some application for business or ecosystems. So all together, it is very complex and take care of each and every generic way of development. But what people are now thinking, why we use this unified platform? No, we should not use unified platform. So we use application enablement platform, means for a particular applications, I should have one platform, different application, different platform. And obviously I will do the infrastructure, application centric infrastructure. If I have to do smart city project, related to the traffic movement, I should have CCTV camera in different places or the roadside sensors in different places. My application should be that way, infrastructure is designed, and accordingly my application platform will be there. And automatically, I do this application-centric infrastructure. I need device and sensor innovation to satisfy the application-centric infrastructure. And obviously, we need one kind of this application business innovation in that level. And finally, we need we need this data integration, whatever coming from the application, this from different corners, some data coming from some part of the city, another data is coming from another part of city, those some data is giving partial information, some other data is giving partial integrations informations, because a roadside 4-lane crossing, there may be 5-lane or six way crossings. Every crossings will have multiple sensor, and multiple sensors give partial data. We need data integrations and huge data, that's a big data. We do analytics. And why we do analytics? Because we want to control the overall systems. And finally, it integrated with the application so that business innovation can take place. This is the present requirement. It is. So, if I go in details, IoT, it talks about three things. One is operational technology, that each and every device do some sensing, actuating, and they do some operations on that. We have information technology for communication purpose, and we have smart object to take some decision its own. So it's basically three important things: the communication technology or information technology, one is operational technology, and smart object can do intelligent task. That means if temperature goes beyond certain limit, so immediately the microwave oven, the AC can be switched off or switched on. Microwave can be switched off if time is over or time out. All these smart action can be taken place. So beyond the hive, if I look where it is used, IoT, municipal IoT, which is very, very popular nowadays, and lot of projects are going on in India, that is smart city, smart grid, smart wastage management, sometimes smart transport management, some municipal service, all these things comes under municipal IoT. Industrial IoT connected the factory automations, though it was earlier there, but intelligence is built in now. Smart agriculture, smart logistics, and biggest is now a separate, very important one is medical IoT. So medical IoT is separate. If you look into this, IoT of medical things or medical internet of things, that is smart hospital, that ICU, any patient is there, all devices can be connected, and doctor sitting in one place, they can see, monitor, take actions, all these things possible. And other part is every data we are collecting, the records are very, very important. And the electronic records, maintenance, and analysis. So, we have connected things or objects which can be controlled from anywhere. We can control anything. And if required, it will go inside by data analytics. And if required, we can take some actions. All these we can do by orchestration or sitting in one place, getting information, analyzing, and taking actions. So orchestration is one of the options which is possible. Now we reach to the scenario where we need dependability, depends on IoT, and we have to trust the IoT, whatever we are getting, and whatever informations this IoT device is generating, or data security or data management point of view, the security has to be built in. So we have three things in one. One is dependability, trust, the data are real data, no one has changed it, or data is genuine, that, and security, the data, no one changed anywhere. All these things play a big role, and if you go through the IoT present day framework, these three things are need to be looked very seriously, because today's scenario, the convergence of discipline, tools, methodology is coming in picture. Convergence means the pathological lab, that is one place, hospital is another place, general hospital, specialized hospital, super specialty hospital in another place. And these three, assume these three places, they have the data of a one patient, they have to exchange their data collected from different devices, IoT devices. They need to converge and combine these to get patient data, complete patient data, instead of incomplete partially at pathologic lab or general hospital or super hospital, combining them. While combining them, data has to be genuine. No one should know this. All these things has to be considered in whole aspect. So there is a vertical divisions of the data, there is horizontal divisions of data, and so on, things can come up. All data are generated by a kind of IoT device, including human, that is doctor in this case. They are writing prescriptions, they are doing, feeding some symptoms, those are also comes in picture. So if you look into the security challenges in internet at present, we need IDS, intrusion detection system. We need IPS, intrusion prevention system. We need honeypots to avoid all attacks, to bring it to one place. Secure socket layer, firewall, PKI, IPsec, then DNS, XML, spam, virus, digital signature, and so on. And antivirus, patches, routers, so many things for privacy, security, mobility, efficiency, and trust building in the systems. This is one security challenges. These are a subset of security challenges is used in internet. Some of them having solution, some of them partial solutions, and all of them based on implementations, either it is vulnerable or it is good. So implementations is one of the important criteria. So bits and pieces putting together, we can make a secure systems. Similarly, in case of IoT, the new landscape of security, we have a lot of problems. First of all, identification of IP address or identification of the objects, which is a necessity, like domain name service, we have ONS, object naming service, which is basically one kind of domain name service, which identify each and every IoT device based on their product, code, and related service. So this has to be secure, and correct identification is required. Similarly, overlay, peer-to-peer, grid, we need transcontinent virtual organizations which can do a lot. DDoS is another distributed denial of service in internet. Here it is domino effect. XML message document, zettabyte data, there is a problem. If you look at the intrusion and malware, here it is spontaneous massive attack. The attack is very huge because billions, millions of devices, some cases it goes to more than 1 million devices, and spontaneous attacks is very, very efficient in this. For example, if you go to the darknet, if you are able to find someone to attack, someone's device to attack, You can go to the darknet, you can pay money in whatever way, Bitcoin or Ethereum or some that cryptocurrency. There's party available, they have a lot of IoT devices available. They use those IoT devices to massive attack on this spontaneous attack into the target. So the target will not move at all. So it can be utilized this. So illicit content to illicit communications, asymmetric cryptography to quantum cryptography related distribution of secret, and computer virus to physical attack of individuals. So whole security ball game, what is internet, is totally changing in IoT system. Why be concerned about IoT? My question will come, IoT is yet another computer. All of the same issue, what we have, present computer, that is access control, vulnerability management, patching, monitoring, same thing is there. But imagine you have a network of 1 million devices. Any compromised device is entry of attackers and destroy everything. It's very difficult to identify which device among 1 million devices are compromised. So it is a real challenge to keep each and every IoT device connected in a network to keep secure and act according to the design. If we look into the varieties of IoT protocols used in IoT device, I have not looked into the sensing part. We assume that sensor sense. We are only talking about the communication and networking technology part. There are communication media, Wi-Fi, WiMAX, Bluetooth, near field communication, long time evolution, Bluetooth low energy. All these are available physical layer communication with the radio transmissions. Then obviously we have a MAC layer, and this MAC layer totally depends on which technology we are using. We are using ZigBee or GOF, or there are plenty of options for link layer protocols. As I mentioned, there are multi-party, multi-group, different group is coming in different options. For example, I mentioned ZigBee, GOF, then your Sigfox, LoRa, like this, lot of options available in MAC layers. And each and every MAC layers has to communicate with the IPv6 or IPv4 layers. And in between, we need a six low adoption layer. Six stands for IPv6, low stands for low power adoption layer, because the link layer is low power. We are talking about tiny devices, sensors and actuators are tiny devices. And IPv6 or IPv4 packets size minimum is 1400 bytes, whereas the MAC layer it is used here, if I go by ZigBee, it is 27 bytes. So it question is that how 1400 bytes can go through 27 bytes of MAC layer frame is not possible. So that's why we have six low adoption layer. One of them is called 6LoWPAN. The 6LoW wireless personal area network based on ZigBee, there are certain adoptions where the IPv6 or IPv4 packets fragmented and sent in multiple frames, and obviously at the receiver reassembly. And those who have worked in security, they know the fragmentation is a disease, and or not disease, better to say that loopholes, which attacker used the tiny fragmentation attack, then like this, there are a lot of attacks available based on fragmentations. Fragmentation of packets leads to multiple type of attacks. And that's why IPv6, the fragmentation of options has removed. Whereas considering this is the 6th law, the IP version 6 or this to the MAC layer, fragmentation is mandatory. And as a result, there are a lot of attacks are inherited here. And how to stop these attacks are big questions. So 6th law functions leads to a lot of attacks. Similarly, it comes to transport layer. This is basically UDP type, and you can assume that UDP transport layer practically not exist because that option is incorporated in other way. So it comes to the constant application layer, COAP. Constant COAP or MQTT or DCE or ACE, that is device identification composition engine with trusted computing group, which Microsoft Azure is used. ACE is the authentication, authorization, and constant environment that options. There are so many constant protocol came up in picture. That is DTLS is another constant protocols, which is datagram transport layer security protocol. This constant is coming because the sensors are having power constant, which is more dominance here. The battery, longevity, and other things will come in picture. As obviously, because of less power, memory and computation has to be. Over and above, communication cost is very high, and that makes battery power wastage very high or use. Forced us, all communication protocol should be minimum as communication is possible, so that power consumption should be less. Due that, these protocols, whatever is mentioned here, COAP, MQTT, DTLS, 6LoWPAN or 6Low, all are vulnerable to multiple attacks. And this is one of the present day attack options. So if anyone wants to do any kind of research, publication, and contribute effectively, please target these protocols. One of them is MQTT, that is Message Queuing Telemetry Transport Protocol, where concept is there is a broker which takes data from a publisher and give it to the internet client. You assume that we have a lot of sensors, and all these sensors can be considered as publishers. Why? They generate data at a certain interval. Whenever there is a change in things happen or periodicity, it generates data. Publisher always publish. Broker in between, it becomes a subscriber. It subscribes to the sensors. As and when data available, data should be given to the subscriber, that is broker. Once data collected, broker acts as a publisher for the internet client, or anyone sitting in one place wants to know the data, what is going on. And that is also possible. That is, again, broker become publisher, and the client, like us, wants to know the data, will be the subscriber. So it's a public subscription model, and the broker time to time act as subscriber, sometime act as the publishers. And this, there are a set of messages. If you look into this, around 11 messages are there, and you can play with those messages and you can create havoc in the system. So sort of attacks possible in this protocol. For example, I can have it. Evil twin. Anyone have no idea, any idea about the, there is a term called evil twin in wireless network. You have access point, you put on Ruse access point or Rug access point, and that will act as the original access point. Then that's why you call evil twin of the original access point and do lot of wrong things. Similarly, evil broker can be here, evil client can be there, the data generation can be spoofed. All these things can be possible here. But very less work has been done in this MQTT. Similarly, if you come to COAP, it's a constant protocols, client-server options. You get data from a certain similar kind of things. And it has a lot of works is available. We remember, I am not talking about the routing protocols here, which comes under network layer. There are plenty of works already done. Security point of view, attacks and other things, plenty of works has been done. I am not talking that part. RPL, routing protocol layer. I am not talking here. We have advanced message queuing protocol, AMQP. And here is also publishers, the data generator of the sensors, sends the data to an exchange. And exchange, every consumer has to subscribe to the exchange and get the data, and this it will be queue, and from queue they will collect. So a MQP broker between the data generator and the consumer. And obviously, here is again series of attacks possible. Now come to multicast domain name system, which is also a very, very important requirement in IoT, where multicast domain name system used to find a device in a local network, and it is like domain name servers, but it is in different way. Who is having official printer local? It will be sending to each and every devices, and the one device having it will inform, I am so and so, my IP address is this. So this is will alias name getting IP address, but it's multicast, because today's scenario broadcast is totally stopped. It is a local broadcast or multicast to get this. And here, again, spoofing, attacks, and lot of things can be possible. Now, if you look into this here in tabular form, functionality of protocol IoT without security, you see MQTT standard is OSS, which is a different group, COAP, IETF, MQP, MQP OSS, DDS is the data distribution service. It's another requirement like MDNS, that is this. This is OMG group. XMPP, which is extensible messaging and presence protocol, which is IETF. So different group come up with different things in different point of time, and their way of working protocols, they have overlapping functionality. Like SSDP is simple service discovery protocol. It is also correct one kind of ONS, that is object naming service. It's a plug and play type. And if we look into the functionality, either they are doing messaging or doing discovery or partially discovery, that is here it is partial discovery. This, as per the function is concerned, exchange a message or discover each other things. If I go to architecture model, it can be client-server or it can be decentralized, these two options. Because MDNS is, multicast DNS is decentralized, sent to everyone, anyone can answer. If you go to the interaction model, either public subscribe or request response type. And if you go here, transport protocol used, MQTT is written TCP, but here is a catch. Most of the people confuse with MQTT. They mention that MQTT works above TCP or use TCP protocols. The answer is partially correct. It works on both. MQTT, which is now available in almost every web browser in wire network, in WebSocket, as in the WebSocket, a MQTT version available, which use TCP. But if you go MQTT for sensor network or Internet of Things, those tiny devices, it is based on UDP. So this slide, preparation time, these things not taken care of. So you have to remember, in wireless scenario, where tiny devices are there, there is no concept of TCP, so it goes by UDP. COAP, you can say most of the cases, UDP, and partially it can work on TCP. Like this, you will find most of the things we need in wireless network or IoT is UDP. Above the UDP, it should work, user datagram protocol. Now, flip side of major security challenges, if you look into it, CIA and so on. That is, we need confidentiality of data as and when required. Some cases we require security to be built in, all data can be securely transferred. Some cases we require data should not be forged or changed. Next case is the authenticity of the data. When it comes to Internet of Things, authenticity of data comes into two ways. One is, whenever data is originated, data should be signed by data generator. How? We'll see later on in one or two few sentences. That means data originator signed the data. So data authenticity is one. Data is authenticated data. Now, sometime we have to reach who has generated data, that device. So device authenticity is also required. So there are two kinds of authenticity is very requirement is this. Availability is another issue, which standard security, it is not important, but IoT, as we discussed, anytime, anywhere, any things will be available. So always these things will be connected, nothing should be unavailable at the time. So availability is one of the requirement. That is, denial of service has to be avoided. There is a concept called access, but here we have written access, but I feel there is a concept called authorization. I am putting this little back again. If you see that authentication, authorization for constant environment. Here, authentication, authorization, in some other way we can look into it. For example, I have a piece of code. I send it to piece of code to a device to do certain task in the device and get the result back to me. That is required because I have millions of devices. I cannot go each and every device, find it individually, find their things and get it. I can send a piece of code, that is API, or some small piece of code, dynamic code. I can executable code. The code will go to a particular device. When code will reach to the particular device, code to be authenticated, that is genuine or not. Similarly, code will check the environment I reached, that environment is the correct environment or the suspicious environment. So authenticity of the device and platform is required. Once this to be done, then the code will try to do some task, execution task. And this execution task require authorizations. What are the things it will access and what are the things it can do? All these things are defined in authorizations. You can say LDAP or Active Directory Services is one such things where authorizations and everything is defined, but it is a tiny device, constant device. How we can define? So authentication, authorization, and accountability, that is triple A, means what are the tasks it is done, that accounts. AAA is very important one in the IoT. It is a big research topic, and everybody has a requirement in present context. Again, please remember, authentication and authorizations can also map to another kind of things called access control. Ultimately, authorizations implemented using access control, which part will be allowed and which part will not be allowed, it is defined and translated into access control. Reliability is another issue. The task, whatever is done, I will get the response correctly. Repeatability is also another issue. All these are the security issues we have to look into in details. And obviously, these are big issues in this context. Now, let us see. IoT is an evolution technology. Initially, we are bound to the hardware, then software operating system. So operating systems was came in picture, standalone system. Finally, network, web, mobile, cloud, and everything together, it is IoT. I am not talking IoT protocol stacks. I am talking the IoT means everything in the world together. So each and every level security are coming into the security of IoT. So it is a very, very heterogeneous options and challenges is very high. We need to secure in each and every aspect, being mobile device, tiny mobile device, that mobile phone, tablet, laptop, to tiny sensors, to the cluster computing or cloud computing, sending their data, everything comes under IoT security. Now, what are the supported security services available among the protocols which are used for tiny IoT devices? If I look MQTT, authentication system is custom built. There is no proper authentication systems recommended by MQTT. And that's why I mentioned MQTT has lot of bugs or lot of vulnerabilities in terms of security. MQTT, they recommended for TLS, but TLS cannot be implementable in IoT scenario other than the wire network, wireless tiny devices, TLS not applicable. So you may have to go for DTLS, datagram transport layer security. TLS needs transport layer TCP. TCP is not available, so it's not possible. So this is available here because this is talks about wire network. CoAP is a mess. We don't have authentication, authorizations, nothing is available, and confidentiality is built in based on DTLS. If you DTLS is running, CoAP is taking care of the confidentiality. AMQP, there is a SASL protocols for authentication. This is a simple authentication and security layer they proposed, and on that it works. And again, it requires TLS, which is talks about again wire network conservative or transport layers TCP. If you look onto DDS, that is data distribution services, is a customs authentication. Some option for custom authorizations to be implementable, and it works for confidentiality both TLS and DTLS. So DDS is one good options, but we have to remember these two, the customs authentication and custom authorizations that we build in. XMPP, extensible messaging and presence protocol, it is having similar kind of things, but for the wireless network, the IoT network, it is very less options available. Now, security risk of this protocol, if we do some analysis, MQTT is TrueSense authentication service is customized. custom specific, so it's not built in. Authorization service, not at all. Encryption service in wireless scenario, not available. So MQTT is one of the vulnerable protocols, but it is very famous protocols at present in IoT network. So anyone wants to do any PhD guidance or master thesis or publications, they can target MQTT. If you go to COAP, authentication services, not available. Other things have some level of security available. Like this, if you go, MDNS, nothing is available. SSDP, nothing is available. So there are a lot of security loopholes available in IoT systems. I forgot to inform you that I am only talking about data on MOOP. Data on REST, data on MOOP, these two are two different parts of the IoT. First, data generate from the sensors. That data goes to edge device. Edge device is the router or some small server. That edge device collect those data. They do some aggregations or something. Then they send the data to next level and so on. Finally, data reach to the cloud. I am talking data on MOOP till it reach to the cloud. So data on MOOP is I am talking about. Data when it come to REST, that is data in cloud, that is offline, all calculations can be done there. So data security is not at all a big issue because communication is no longer a requirement. Data is not moving from one place to another place. So authenticity, secrecy, then origin authentication, integrity, all these will go away. So data on MOOP, so is, and data on REST, these two are two different work or two different philosophy. I am talking on the data on MOOP or operational technology. Till now, if you have any questions, you can ask, stop me and ask. Otherwise, I will continue. Why it looks so bad? Breakers have a long history and they have robust tools. They have automated network attack tools. If you go to the Kali Linux, that is Wireshark, that is Kali Linux. If you go, you will find their different kind of attack tools, including ARNG, that is attack tools are available. So there are a lot of sophisticated attack tools are available in Kali Linux or similar type. So exploits for most segment of IoT stacks, they have the information. They have physical access of hardware and software. They somehow put that some backdoor in almost all devices because devices in place, they got the option, they put their backdoors. Whoever building this IoT framework, they are still searching for secure toolkits. They do not have any secure toolkits like breakers. Proven methodology, they are also searching for, and they are searching for successful tools. As a result, builders, what they are doing, whoever building this IoT framework, they are taking something from somewhere, party A, party B, party 3, party C, and so on, combining them and creating one IoT systems. Obviously, this IoT system is very fragile and full stack solutions. So no visibility into security or attack surface. Attacker have very, very nice option to enter into any place, anywhere. So if you go that way, look into the possible attacks happen in 2020. One of the attack is Mirai botnet growth in 2020. Also, they have done in 2021, Mirai botnet is one kind of attacks, and this attacks is very old history. I think you all of you know, and this old history, the attacks are multiplying and continuing. And 2020 there was attack in growth. 2021 also there is huge growth in Mirai botnet attack. Please go through the Mirai botnet attack. You will find to know. The second attack is Hickory Hardware Smart Deadbolt Threat. This basically the hardware lock which IoT enable or NFC enables, and the door lock is designed in such a way it can work as IoT device, and it has a sensors. You can give commands and you get the response. So the attacker has come up with some kind of loopholes, and they able to destroy those locks or make it one state. And that's the biggest threat for the places where these door locks are placed. Similarly, Google Home Assistant, the Alexa, had a security breach. Alexa is one kind of IoT devices. I think you have seen Alexa in different people home or on car, inside the car, similar to the Siri and others. You can give commands, voice commands, and Alexa will do for us lot of things. So someone able to use this Alexa, get to know a lot of things and siphon a lot of things, and able to do huge kind of losses of some homes or the resident. Hacked baby monitors, if you know, in certain developed country, they have certain system, they keep their baby in a place and monitor from a distance. And those are definitely IoT device, and people able to hack and able to do a lot of bad things in those devices and create havoc in the systems. So all these are basically telling that IoT device security is very, very important requirement. So one side of the IoT device require convergence, manage the network, the resilience at a scale, number increasing, we require distributed intelligence. They can distributed way do a lot of works, and they can build one applications which things can work. Security resides there, and the security has a lot of problem, compliance and regulations. This is another important things we have to look into its security point of view, because sensor networks or the IoT device can be across the boundary place, and different organization, different compliance and different regulations, different country, different rigorous regulations. And they use different kind of protocols for different devices. And every protocol requires security requirement. Remediations, we have to take that impact and risk. And threat has a diversity, because diverse devices and diverse protocol, diverse things. And obviously, all these things leads to increase huge attack in the system. So we need the security issues to be looked into in serious way. What can not? Billions of connected devices, secure, insecure locations, security may not be built in, not owned or controlled by IT, but data flow through the network is mandatory. So any node in your network can potentially provide access to the IoT network. What is talking? Billions of connected devices is the IoT network. Secure, insecure locations, they are placed. Security may available in some of the devices, may not be available in some of the devices. Some devices in our control, some devices controlled by someone else. But data are flowing through those networks. As a result, security is breaching or security loopholes are many, providing access to the network and potentially access to the code. So this is one important thing you have to remember. Now, attack on only specific IoT devices. If you look into it, the physical attack, that is micro-probing or reverse engineering on the device, but taking the device and doing probing each and everything and doing, that is device, somehow they got it, attacker got it and do physical attack. Attacker can do power analysis attack, that is side channel attacks, timing analysis, power analysis, fault analysis, electromagnetic analysis. The device is working, they can put some probes and do the analysis. There is environmental attack, they can camouflage the environment and the device can do something wrong. Cryptanalysis attack, whatever it is sending and whatever receiving, all the standard attacks are possible here in cryptanalysis. Software attacks, because there is a firmware or OS built in, there is a possibility of software attacks, virus, Trojan horse, logic bomb, worms, denial of service, everything is possible, whatever is a WAN network, a variant of that can be possible. And comes to the network communication, monitoring, overstrapping, traffic analysis, camouflaging, denial of service attack, whatever we can achieve, reflection attack, replication attack, routing attack, flooding attack, nose attack, civil attacks, all these attacks also possible here. What can go wrong? Obviously, our safety will go away. IoT architecture, military, this vehicular network, food, denial of service attack, and we can divert from getting proper service. We can have lot of problems in each and everywhere, specifically denial of service attack, and which is popular in IoT infrastructure. Some attack example. Preliminary stage, a hacker can hack a node, implementation malware, inculcation of malicious node in the network, deploying equipment for intrusion. So, a preliminary stage hacker can do, hack a node, implement some malware in some of the devices, inculcation of malicious node, putting in this, deployment equipment for intrusions. This leads to increase, can be increased to traffic intensity or traffic decreasing traffic intensity. By doing so, packet flooding attacks are possible, vulnerability attacks are possible, jamming attack possible, black hole attack possible, selective forwarding, sidewheel attack, all kind of attacks are possible. And that can be increased or decreased. Leads to denial of service, that is availability, integrity, that is forge, and security, all these things are possible. So internet and IP, if we look, historically joining heterogeneous network, abstraction of a network with two abstracted transport services, that is the thing, and develop towards ubiquitous network technology, internet become the network, IP allows great level of extension link, this is IP. But if you look into the internet of things, device versus host, host or address, in RFID reader or host, if network, device are named RFID tags are devices. So basically, if you look into the device and host, host is addressed by IP, whereas device addressed by RFID tag or something, host need to be reachable, permanent or semi-permanent, using routing capability or deep network, deep in the network, DNS or BGP. But devices may not be reachable all the time, whereas their data should be available, accessible. The security challenges are devices are not reachable all the time, most of the time a device is not connected, there is a possibility. So if you want to make that device patching, is not that easy. Device can be lost or stolen. That is make security difficult when our device is not connected. So if it is lost and stolen, then we have to take care of someone can do some physical or probing and other things. How to stop that? It is a requirement. Devices are not crypto engine. So we cannot use high-end security protocols running computation heavy security protocol or memory heavy security protocols in those devices. Devices have finite life. So all the credential we have to put in the device, that is PKI, that is the public infrastructure, if you see, that has to be lifetime dependent and credential will be lifetime. So no one should utilize when devices die, that credential no one should utilize. Devices are transportable. That means it can cross the border. So whatever built-in contents are or security device are implanted, that should work across the border. So security challenges. Device need to be recognized by many reader. That is also another, because the reader is changing with respect to time, complexity and others. And if you look into the security work and Internet of Things, we require risk analysis because we cannot make each and every device perfectly secure. So all device, some deficiency will be there. So risk analysis is necessary. So heterogeneous device, which device can do? The device analysis is also necessary. Crypto capability and expert analysis and each and every device also require. Security objective, the device is privacy protected, identity protected, or traffic analysis protected, or the combined, that is also another requirement. Identity and identifier management, that is every device will be identified across the globe or not, and how we will identify, that is another issue. So we started with this. Application-centric infrastructure, Bureau is the science, and we reached here. Now, we reached the business innovation. The same thing we have written here, the data integration, big data analysis, and those things. And device and sensor innovations, what we discussed just now, we need here. And we need proper service to be built in across the protocol stack. And we have to build a lot of security framework for end-to-end encryption, device-level security, anti-tampering, physical security, all these things we have to do. Now, comes down to operational technology and IT. What we are talking is the operational technology. What is we have is the IT, information technology. Information technology any-to-any, but operational technology connectivity usually hierarchical. Lot of sensor connected to edge device connected to next level device and so on. Not directly any to any options available. Network postures, if you look at confidentiality, integrity and availability, that is a requirement for information technology. Whereas here, availability is first, integrity is second, and confidentiality is the last. So the way it looks is different. Security solution, if you look, cybersecurity and data protections, but operation technology, control and safety is one of the important requirements. So access control and safety is requirement. Response to attack, information technology, you can quarantine certain or shut down to mitigate the service. The machine can be shut down or quarantined for this. But operation technology, non-stop operation, IoT device, you cannot stop operations. It may be working for certain purpose, maybe mission goal. So never stop, even if breached also. So this situation is totally different. So if you want to see the miserable track records, you can find it. Luckily, most tests are consumer are of consumer IoT until now. Testing industrial, municipal, other IoT much trickier. Most have heterogeneous brownfield deployment. And there are sort of things you can go and check it, because every application demands a different kind of security. All in one cannot be possible. Every application is application specific security, and it's not that easy. So if you look into the WASP IoPT project and overall IoT security, you can get a lot of information, the attack surface, what has happened till today, vulnerability list also you can find there. Reference solutions are coming, some of them are available. Aggregate community resources also you'll get in this project. Guidance for developer also available, IoT specific security principle and IoT framework also visible. So if you go top 10 WASP IoT top 10 in 2014, I have not seen after that. There is insecure web interface, that is the category, and there is a what are the problem, what is the recommendations. You can find it in net easily. Insufficient authentication and authorizations is another kind of category. You can go through what are the recommendations. Insecure network service, lack of transport encryptions, privacy concern, insecure cloud interface, insecure mobile interface, insufficient security configurability, insecure software and firmware, and poor physical security. They have come up with 10 category of in 2014, and latest one you can find it from the net. These are first case, it is basically talking about weak guessable or hard-coded password. It's a standard, you can know insecure network service and so on. I want to keep some time for discussion, so that's why I'm moving a little faster. Principle of IoT security, assume the hostile edge, means where network is placed, you have to assume it's a hostile place, and we have to come up with security so that hostile scenario also it is remain. And anything you will do, testing is very difficult, and because it says millions order or large number and lot of other things available in limit what you can, best option is limit what you can, life cycle support, because the test, all these things, data aggregation and unpredictable, plan for the worst, because prevention is better than cure, so plan for the worst. So accordingly, security should be built in. The long haul also, attacker target weaknesses, all these things, end-to-end authentication is another important things, entity-to-entity authentications. This is requirement for IoT security, including system hardening. If someone get that IoT device, is self-destructible, so that no one can get anything from there. All these things. Another important things I forgot, protect uniformity, so that this will be. So framework for assessment, if you do based on the prototype, tell IoT deployment model, design like a checklist of the benchmark, test your mobile connected through this, and test one after another. Let me keep some of them. Example of edge considerations, are communication encrypted? Is storage encrypted at the edge device? How is logging is performed in edge device? Is there any updating mechanism in edge device? Are there default password exist? Are the offline security features? What are the offline security feature? Is transitive ownership address? This is last one is very, very important. Data is moving from one to another, to another, to another. Who will be the owner of the data? That's a big questions remain. So these questions one by one to be answered. Similarly, at the gateway, where this data is encryption interrupted? Because if interrupt, you can get a lot of things. Is there any replay or denial of service defensive capabilities? is the local storage. Their local storage is, it is encrypted. Is there anomaly detection capability? Is there logging and altering capability at the gateway? 6, near router. If you know that IoT framework, you will find IPv6. All devices are connected one by one to 6 BR router, the border router. And the border router is considered as a gateway. And gateway, these conditions should be built in. If you look into the mobile, what countermeasure in place for theft or loss the device? That has to be properly built in. Does the mobile authentication degrade other component of security? So authentication can degrade the other component. Is local storage done securely? Is there an audit trail of mobile interactions? Because anything gone wrong, I can verify. Can mobile be used to enhance the authentication for other component? All these we have to do. Similarly, cloud consideration, I don't want to talk here. I will move to the next, so that I can keep some time for question answer. So final thoughts, security and privacy is a platform problem in IoT protocol. One-stop solutions are not available. So every application demands a specialized solution. Regulations still are evolving, not yet available. Many countries are yet to come up with guidelines. Consumer may find some problem, but business should continue. Security can be a differentiator. So different kind of security, different applications, and different kind of service. So I'll put it here as my talk end. So if anyone having any questions, please let me know. It's not possible to talk everything. Okay, so anyone have any questions?
Participants, you may unmute yourself and directly ask question.
No one having questions. Good. Sangram, you can have questions.
Anyone, Jayashree? Oshini? Hello?
Okay, one question is, how does blockchain can help in IoT? In the chat box, one of them have written.
Abhishek Dahal.
How does blockchain benefit IoT? This is, yes, paper publication point of view, yes. Answer is yes, blockchain can help. But practical consideration point of view, blockchain benefits IoT is doubtful. Because when it comes to blockchain, your whole concept of that POW, POA, what is POW, POA? Proof of work, proof of stake, proof of authority, proof of all these things will come up, and the chain building and chain verifying and committing is consume a lot of resources, and in terms of space, in terms of communication, in terms of computing, which is a big issue in IoT network. So on IoT, blockchain, if at all, has to be lightweight. And a lot of works are coming up, how lightweight authentication can be, lightweight blockchain-based techniques can be implemented in IoT. So please go through the lightweight options. You'll manage consensus protocols. They are coming up in different kind. Please look into this. Yes, it is possible. But for publication set, you can. For practical sense, doubtful. Now coming to, for a sudden attack, how OT would be prevented? Sudden attack is, that is basically operation technology, data on move, whenever attacks happen, it's a spontaneous or instance attack, and those attacks are very heavy, and usually that has to be localized. And if we can localize those attacks, we can confine in a zone and we can proceed. I'm giving one example of this is Cloudflare. You have heard about Cloudflare, which is a big service provider. And this Cloudflare mechanism is that if someone will do the distributed denial of service into Cloudflare machines, then Cloudflare makes that few machines as the honeypot or is a victim. And all attacks will end up in those machines. They make sure that those machines will die. Okay, one or two or few machines will die. In reverse, they identify, analyze those attacks, and they create reverse attack to the attacker and make the attacker to sleep for how many hours, God knows. So that's why no one tries for the Cloudflare. So what I wanted to say that they localize the attack and bring into one device or two devices and do. Similar concept we have to use in this IoT scenario. And usually there are several papers exist. If one IoT device is victim, let it be remain victim. Don't put in the data from that victim or this, isolate it, throw it out. Now question is that how I will understand that that is a victim? Obviously, we should have some statistical method or some minimum artificial intelligence or some level of heuristics or some level of small some level of deep learning, but the deep learning framework, number of features and number of layers in the implementation will be as minimum as possible to come up with some usable decisions that normal or abnormal. If they find the abnormal, they drop those cases and continue. So, true sense, Jayashree Karmakar, you are right. AI and machine learning and deep learning nowadays is used for authentication, stop cyber attacks, all those things are used. For example, if someone wants to spoof sitting in Kolkata and telling that the person is from Guwahati, is easy to detect in IoT attacks. IoT with a simple environment information to be collected. So Guwahati temperature, Guwahati, some environmental consideration, if we take Guwahati and put it together with the authentication scheme using some intelligent heuristics, we can get a hash functions, which is different from the Kolkata person who cannot place the present condition of the Guwahati, so easily can be caught. So like this, there are several concepts coming up in how to utilize intelligence of the environment and others, and machine intelligence and deep learning and other things for IoT network, which I have not talked here. Dhananjay Kumar, you asked how COAP provide end-to-end acknowledgement. COAP is a client-server protocols, and the client-server protocols, whatever is available, it is going to implement. If you go through the client server mechanism, you will find there are multiple ways exist. There are ACK, NAC, all these things are there between two devices. So this, if you go through, you will find there is option called end-to-end acknowledgement option is there, but it's not that what we understand in TCP and others, but it's a different way. You can go through, you'll find it. That's a client-server protocol, CON, CONAC, CON this, CON that options. Okay. Surajit Das, if we want to know more about his voice book, we can follow, sir. Sorry, there is no proper book exist for this. This is evolving, as I told you earlier. This is a very, very new, and as I also mentioned earlier, that different group is coming out, different kind of protocols, and As a result, there is no commonality exist between groups. SIGFOX groups is one, LoRa group is another, the other group is another. Like this, there are multiple groups exist. And as a result, there is no uniform things available and no proper book available. Which can I suggest to you? Anyone else, anyone questions?
Thank you so much, sir, for your information, sir.
Thank you. Anyone has any questions? But as I mentioned, it is a very, very fertile area for new researcher to do. But you have to remember, this area is not that easy because very less people are having knowledge. That is the first thing. Second thing, you have to have, first of all, creating test bed may not be that difficult because you can have BeagleBone, you can have Raspberry Pi, you can have Galileo, Intel Galileo, and their constant, you can set up Galileo. But that scale up to 10 or 20 or 50 in a lab. So you can do some test bed, or you can use Mininet, the emulation environment, but person has to know, very knowledgeable. And the simulation environment, no one has asked. I am telling you, Contiki Kuja, which is tiny ways above, it works. That is possible to implement. Or NS3, we have option for certain simulation environment creations and doing it. That is available. And if you buy Zigbee that sensor network, today it is fine, tomorrow maybe new things will come up. You can do some kind of test, but you can do certain kind of experiments. But you have to know little bit of tiny ways how to compile and how to do it. Best option, if you want to do test bed, you buy Raspberry Pi, BeagleBone or Intel Galileo or similar kind of things with several sensors, and you can try your level best at the test bed. If you don't want to test bed, go to Contiki Kuja or network simulator and use it there. You can do certain kind of experiment. If you require any help, you can contact to the our PhD student. They can help you. I have not mentioned another interest area, which NDN, named data network security and named data network usage in IoT, that I have not mentioned. That is another story, because sensor network create data and data can be used as data network, named data network concept, and their security, their all these things also comes in. That is another set of things. Those who are interested, you can contact our PhD student. Thank you.
Sir.
Yes.
Sir, if we use network simulator, which one will be better, network simulator 2 or 3? Or if we don't use Raspberry Pi, will it create any problem if we use only network simulator?
Okay. So network simulator 2, you can forget it because it has no meaning now. Present scenario, if you want to do IoT related or any work you want to do, network simulator 3 only. Okay. And if you do not do Raspberry Pi or others, only use network simulator and do certain kind of work, yes, you can publish to a tier. You know, there are different tier of conference and journals. Definitely you can go up to tier, one tier below the journal or conference. The top tier is very difficult to go unless you have the test bed or mathematical analysis. Only simulation result with good mathematical analysis, you can target top tier conference or journal. But if you do only simulations, protocol and simulations, you can publish up to just below top tier journal or conference. Okay.
Thank you, sir, for enlightening on the different security issues of Internet of Things. I hope that all the participants are really motivated from here to take it further in their research career. Thank you, sir, for being here in spite of your very busy schedule. I hope we will get in touch and we'll get your valuable suggestions in future too. not only for the participants, but also for the NIT Sikkim fraternity also. And also looking forward to your physical presence in the near future, whenever this pandemic situation will be over. So thank you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you for your...
Thank you, sir.
Thank you for your options. Let me see in future what we can do.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Bye. Good night.
Good night, sir. So, participants, so the third session of this day is already completed. So, you may leave now. One request is that some of the participants are joining through different names. So, it will be very difficult to record their attendance as well as whenever they will appear in evaluation test. So, it will be very difficult to identify them. So, in that case, you will be marked absence and your marks will not be counted. For example, I can say that I have seen that Rashtriya Navodaya Sarva Shiksha Mission like that. One ID is joining here instead of his registered name. And one was there BDO Itahar like that. So request is that don't use a different name. Use your registered name. That was already mentioned in that initial confirmation participation email. You should always use your registered name. Otherwise, it will be very difficult for us to track the attendance and also track your evaluation test performance. So don't do this. Who have used, just mention that your genuine name, in which name you have used for registration purposes, so that it will be useful for us to track your attendance and evaluation test. So for today, it's all. Good night to all of you. And we hope that we'll be again joined together tomorrow morning at 10:50 a.m. So all the best. Good night. Sir.
Good night, sir.
Thank you, sir.